And welcome back to Runner's Fortune, the Library of Taba.
Yay!
It's been a little bit, but where we last left our adventuring party, you all had accepted a contract to go out and deal with a pack of wolves that had been stealing the livestock of the city of Kataras. And you all had gone and, after attempted negotiations with the wolves to get them to leave, you ended up fighting them. And you killed most of them, other than two, which you've convinced to come along with you. Between Everlee and Chodrak, you each have a little wolf companion right now. And, you split up the party. Chodrak and his wolf. Everlee and her wolf.
And then I was with them.
Yes. And Caleigh stayed outside the city. While the other four headed into the city to turn in proof of their completion of the quest, gain their reward, and figure out some next steps. What you received at this point is you got another quest from Artinius' guild, the Guild of Adventurers, to go on out and find a mine that is a lost mine that was said to have forged magical weapons of grand proportions. And there's a couple of tiers to this quest. It's you know, they said, you know what, this is, we trust you all that you can probably get it done. They don't give this quest out to anybody. And that you have at least a decent chance of living through it. But there's,
we'll see.
There is, you get one amount if you just go out and find it and find proof and are able to return proof that it exists. There is a second tier. If you go and then you actually go inside and make it functional and or clear it out of whatever may be inside of it or anything like that, make it safe for others to go to. And there's a third level, if you actually can then bring some other people to it afterwards and guide them through. Well, you all left the city then, and you sold your extra goods that you received from the dead wolves. And you all rounded the last little small hill, and looked down, and standing in between two groups is Allerton, whom you believe you had slain earlier, and Absidee may have seen in a semi-living state recently.
Maybe. Only Allerton, Absidee knows. I know.
It's been so long.
I know.
I don't know who I am.
Me either. It's okay.
And that is where we begin.
Bless you.
Thank you.
He's so excited.
As you all are looking at Allerton, he does look a slight bit different than you last remember seeing him.
Okay.
For one, he has, his skin is sliced many, many times from where Everlee used her spell to just slice him. They are gaping wounds, They're not bleeding.
That's kind of horrifying.
Does he look like very, like, almost like undead?
Well, the head is like this.
Oh.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
It's held on by a little, like, the throat is still attached,
geez.
But the skin itself is all just ripped like, through.
Yeah.
Gross.
Doesn't quite seem to hold himself with the same poise that he did when he first collected Absidee and then the rest of the group and loaded ahead of you to bring you to Brixera the first time.
Absidee, go talk to him.
And this is a good representation of how far we are.
Yes. Yeah.
30-ish.
Yes.
Feet.
Yes.
Caleigh's definitely scared. And bamps out the wings and is, like, at the ready because she's not sure what's happening.
Sterling looks over to Abs and goes, hey, go touch it. Like, nudges him. Go talk to it.
You're the one who likes to make friends?
I don't want to talk to it. It looks gross.
Well, I don't know if he wants to talk.
I'll go with you.
Is there, like, a rock near me at all?
There is, yeah. Lots of... How big a rock are you looking for?
Big enough. I just want to throw it and see if, like, am I hallucinating? Like, Caleigh does not... Am I hallucinating?
Okay.
So I just want to throw it at him and see what happens.
As I see this happening, I am going to cast Arcane Shield after I see her throw the rock.
Okay.
Just spend 4 points and get 16.
Okay. Go ahead and make a dexterity check for me.
Oh, boy.
I'm going to hide behind my wolf.
Nobody can see you past the wolf.
Yeah.
I'm not here.
That's an 18 roll.
Okay.
I've forgotten what to add my modifiers, right?
Yes, yeah, like myself level.
So that's 20, a dirty 20.
Okay. Well, you throw a rock and it does pass through, or it does hit the torso.
She goes, ah!
Does he respond?
And it bounces off the back. The head kind of rotates.
And she really goes, oh my god!
no longer held by any ligaments or anything, it just rotates straight backwards, full 180 degrees to take a look at you.
I'll turn to Sterling and be like, I don't think he came to speak to us, so if you want to start this...
We should throw more rocks at it.
You should run in and kill him.
Alright.
You all have forbidden knowledge.
Well,
yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Is he talking about that thing that touched us?
Yeah.
No, I think he's talking about the traveling screen that we can go through.
Oh.
That would make sense. We're like whispering to each other across vast distances.
Said.
I'm not quite sure what she said, but what she said.
Yeah.
Does anybody have good hearing?
Oh, I have excellent hearing.
I guess I'm gonna step in front of Absidee, just like enough to like block something if something happens. Be like, what are you gonna do about it? But then like hide behind my shield.
Must there be something I do about it?
Why are you here if not?
To speak.
See, he doesn't want to talk.
His body is shaking a little bit as he's talking, like it's not quite right.
Like he's unstable.
Yes.
I go for it. I take, like, what am I, 5, 10, 15? I take, like, 10 forward. And then I say, and I'm holding out my sword, and like, then speak. I'm so scared, but I'm trying not to shake. I'm like,
I am trying. This body isn't in the best condition.
Can we try to heal him?
I was thinking of it, but only if you are all
also
okay with it.
Yeah.
Not used to having a body.
Oh, jeez.
So, are you not Allerton?
Who is Allerton?
Oh my god, is this an Alec?
And then the mic dropped.
Oh, shit.
Then who are you?
You would refer to me, well, most would refer to me as a specter, as a ghost.
Of who?
Those that know more.
No, you're good. You're good. He ignores you. His head is still turned backwards and facing you at this point.
I'm still scared, but a little less so. I'm like...
Those that know more call me an Alep.
God.
What's an Alep?
All
remember, I rolled a one.
Call me... And you all didn't share knowledge that you remembered about this Alep with any of each other.
Yeah, but I didn't say anything about an Alep.
Were you the... We knew the name, but we didn't know what it was.
Correct.
Yeah.
Absidee was the only one that actually knew
what it was.
It.
Yeah, okay.
I completely forgot that it even existed,
right.
That I heard that word.
You all would refer to me as the one... who placed an image in your heads.
Okay.
Should we heal him?
Yeah.
It?
The body. They?
Do you have a gender pronoun?
Do you
that
have
you
preferred pronouns that we could use?
I did once, but I do not remember... them now.
So you don't care.
So we'll confirm on it.
Yeah, I like it.
It shall be acceptable.
Until we name you, at least.
What is the purpose for taking on this body?
Well, I can't speak otherwise.
Makes sense.
It was uninhabited.
True that.
So that means Allerton is actually gone. Perfect.
Yeah.
How did you get the money back through the portal?
Is Allerton...
The
body that you're in.
I see.
What I know...
No, he is not... gone.
Well, the soul? Is the soul gone?
No.
Okay.
At this point, I put my sword back.
Pass him.
Interesting.
When I took this body, he shall soon be like me.
Oh,
interesting.
Tormented, twisted, unable to move on with a burning secret.
Well, sucks to be him.
Yeah.
He will take this secret and... pass it to all that he can until someone deals with it to his satisfaction.
What is his secret?
So do you
know what his secret is?
I do not know. You would have to ask him.
I think we'd rather not.
But he may answer in a way that pains you.
Give me a hand on head.
So are you here to make sure that we handle your secret to your satisfaction?
Yes and no.
If I heal your body, the body you're inhabiting, would it be easier for you to speak?
Maybe a little bit. I am still not used to a body and do not feel like I can keep this up forever, regardless the state of the body.
Then, so you aren't suffering more than you apparently already are. What do you want from us?
Well, I want you to find the library and re-bring it to the world. Its secret has been lost to most, but still we must search
forever. We're going.
Until it is found and we can use its power to take over the lands to the south, namely Gainsworn, for without it we shall never win.
Can you give us any hint towards where the library is so we can head in the right direction, other than north?
I gave you all the information that remains. I am old. My brain does not work much as it used to.
And he seems to be struggling more now than he was before.
Mm-hmm. Trying to get there right now. No promises. We can do it before you. Well, I guess an Aleph would stick around forever. This is the body he's in to use to speak. It's deteriorating. Okay.
Yeah. The connection between the two. He the Aleph will last until
we satisfy his.
Yep.
Well, we are trying to do that. It's been a slow start for us. But
we're on the road.
We're on the way soon.
I bring a warning. There are those who do not wish for this to be found. Be cautious. Not everyone is as they seem. The big man may be more friend than you think, and the little green may be more enemy.
I'm
than
going to mind sliver him real quick and some shadow damage
on.
Go ahead.
Oh, hit.
I will give you advantage because this is a stationary, very stationary nice. Target.
Natural 20.
Okay.
So he gets 4 plus 2, which is the max damage, plus my bonus, or just the max damage?
So it'd be...
The d4
plus
2.
Yeah, it'd be max damage.
6 plus the bonus.
Plus your bonus.
So that's
plus
10 already. Plus... So 13 total.
Okay.
And if it seems to have done what it's done twice to shadow damage... Peek out behind Sterling. Pew! Get back in. What did you do, Sterling? Practice magic?
Oh no! I did again, guys.
Sterling's like, what?
It's the power of your mind.
Yeah.
What does that do?
So I try to hit him with that.
You definitely hit him.
Okay.
What does it do?
Well, a piece of the chest falls off.
Ah!
Ew.
Gross.
Caleigh tries not to throw up.
I'm sorry, I had to work the other day.
The head lulls again.
Oh, no.
Still facing backwards.
I do not understand this magic.
Who's the green guy?
Right? Who's little
green? Who's little green?
Maybe the goblin who runs the city? Isn't there a goblin that runs the...
Not the city.
Yes, the capital or the country?
Mm-hmm.
Oh.
Oh.
Bricks. No.
Oh.
I don't know somebody's name.
That makes sense to me.
Count Cristo.
Count
yeah.
Cristo, yeah, that's... I think that's what it means as a little green.
You haven't met Count Cristo, though, right? You just heard
no, we just
heard
about
him.
Cool.
He's a goblin?
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, he took some damage.
So, gosh, I don't even remember what we remember Bricks there last time. We left on okay terms, right? Like, that we know
you
of.
Left on okay
we
terms,
all left
yes.
on okay terms.
He just gave you gifts when you left.
Yeah.
And we were
and
awkward
you were
about
welcome
it,
back
but like,
anytime.
Yeah, anytime we'd like to go back.
Okay. So, that we know of, Brixair might be weird, but is still our friend.
Right.
Yeah. I'm sure he understands, like, the nature of gaining trust, you know?
Yeah,
you
I'm sure.
Break some rooms.
Yeah, I'm sure.
Go look at things you're not supposed to. Earn each other's trust.
Find each other's fun rooms. Has he stopped talking? He's like, dead.
Well, I mean, he's still gone. Standing.
Hello?
The body's
still
there? Standing and shaking. I am still here.
It's
little green.
Sorry.
Thank you for the warning.
Did you do something?
He doesn't feel it.
The world is sideways now.
Oh.
I was trying to make you better. Well, I didn't.
Did it work?
Obviously
no.
not.
He can't see his chest because he's facing the other way.
Oh, man.
Well, shot him in
there?
The back.
Was
the
there
front,
anything
the,
else?
Wait.
Any other warnings we need before
yeah.
we head off?
There are always warnings. Many,
what?
Many warnings. The world is dangerous.
Okay, but is there any knowledge you need to give us?
Find no. Find is wrong. The word is make the key.
Make the key.
Need the key.
As he's stuttering, I'm gonna do something bold. I'm gonna grossly just reach out my hand and, like, pick him up and move him to the side and just flag everyone to let's go. Just gonna put him to the side and be like, okay, see you soon,
and
turn
you're
around.
Setting him down, he does crumple as you,
great.
You set him down, his legs don't hold weight and you just end up lowering him straight to the ground.
Oh. Okay, like looking at her hands like, oh.
Make the key.
Oh, yeah. Make the key.
Exactly as I planned.
So do you, those of you that were up on the hill, come join
yeah.
the...
Yeah, yeah, I'll yeah. definitely group up. Is that like early afternoon, late morning?
Yeah, yeah, early afternoon.
Yeah, it's like level up o'clock, I think.
Well, that was, I haven't seen quite that happen before, and I've been around the block a time or two.
Well, but you've never dealt with whatever that was before,
and
have you?
No. No, I haven't.
Oh, yeah, you're not.
Oh, he hasn't been
have
touched.
Not been touched.
Your brain didn't
yeah,
get
what's
groped.
What's going on?
That's nothing. You don't want to know.
This person yeah. thing, man, it caused us a lot of pain. That's all. That's
okay.
All you, that's all you need to know.
Hmm. Maybe he's here. Would you like him to touch you?
Do I want him to touch?
Or to tell you
me?
This, to share the secret with you.
Do you want the secret that the rest of us have?
Yeah. Do you want the secret to me?
I feel like that's a loaded question.
You'll know where we're going.
From the way you all are looking at me, the answer should be no, but at the same time, I'm really weird, so the answer is definitely yes, at which point his body begins to seize.
Yay.
Nice.
Wow, we're evil.
You think this elk? Do you think this elk's gonna follow us the entire way?
I mean, just
and just like taking bodies that we kill every once in a while, and be like, "How's
here
it going? You're getting warmer.
You're getting colder because you're in the north."
Oh.
<Uh-oh. laughs> What?
You.
Yeah.
I thought it was Timmy. I'm like, oh no, is he dead?
I know,
no.
Right?
Oh shit, we killed him.
No. I'll say, yeah.
I mean, he is bloody, like you all were, but.
I'm gonna wait till he stops seizing and then I'll do some damage control.
Okay.
He's not gonna sleep all tonight.
No, probably not. No. Okay.
We're gonna be sleeping outside anyways. I mean,
while we're waiting for him to finish seizing, does anyone else need any healing or. Wounds.
No. I mean, I have wounds.
Okay, I'm gonna try and get rid of Caleigh's wounds.
Okay.
I have two.
Okay.
Just, I put it up.
So, I would have to roll twice?
Yes.
I should pull up the wound chart, shouldn't I?
That's not a good number. 9, yeah, that doesn't work.
No.
Try it again. I'm sorry, I poked you in the eye instead. I didn't mean to.
Oh, my vision's even more hazy!
Failed. 14 plus 7. 21.
Do you have blurred vision or hazy vision?
Hazy vision. Where is the wound chart?
Oh, it's in the spreadsheet. What did you get?
21.
That succeeds
yes.
on hazy vision.
Alright, yay.
What was the other one? What did you roll?
My first one?
Yeah.
9.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
I just couldn't remember, to be perfectly honest.
Yeah, I rolled a 2.
Okay. So at least I don't have hazy vision. I'm still limping around, though.
I could try and fix that, too, if you want me to.
Yeah.
What do I have to roll for that one?
15.
Oh. Six.
What are you rolling
6
on?
Plus 7?
13.
You're rolling on healing?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I cannot help.
Our other person season. That could help is not here.
Have we taken a short rest yet? No.
That. Okay. Actually, you guys would have taken a short rest while the others were in the city.
Then I'm fine.
Yep.
Then I'm out. My limp's gone.
Oh, okay.
I can yeah. see what you guys mean by.
Oh, that time I rolled 15.
Yeah.
I don't know. Just when my wound went away.
Oh, strange, huh?
Yes. Yeah.
Well?
I don't feel like I've gotten anything new.
Oh, that's right.
You have to wait till you go to bed.
You'll have some nightmares
that's
tonight.
That's helpful.
Sorry.
But we'll let you sleep the
I
whole night.
I always have nightmares.
Oh, boy.
More nightmares. At
oh,
least
great.
You know these ones mean something.
All right. As long as they mean something.
Do you need help with anything? How are you physically...
yeah, I could use some healing. He's gonna attempt a repair check to fix his bowstring.
And he succeeds.
Yay!
20 non-natural.
That is just enough.
Perfect.
For his hazy vision.
True, the vision's hazy.
Is everyone else good? No other wounds.
Healthy. Great. Yep.
Short rest.
I got you.
Thanks.
I got you.
I feel like I should know where it's from.
Yes, you should.
It's fine.
Short rest, you get a quarter of...
One of your
stats, that's what it is.
Yes.
But, yeah. We
and you were short rested with me, right? Because we were waiting for them.
So you can get
yeah, you guys were out moving around and everything, so you didn't get the short rest.
Anybody need healing? Everybody got...
That's all to do with me.
Does Artemis need some healing?
Of course, he does, yes.
Okay, so...
Seven.
I am going to use healing hands.
Okay.
How much does he need healed?
You're welcome.
30. But you guys will probably end up resting before too long.
Okay.
Yeah, Alan takes off half your life.
I'll put 2 magic into it.
Okay.
1d6.
As all their healing.
So 2d6 plus 8.
Yeah.
I walk up to Chodrak and I'm like, I do not understand this magic. I use the shadow on the people outside. They get better. It's just strange. Maybe one day I will learn.
I think it depends on who it is.
Does it just do another 4 or does the bonus double up?
In the streets?
Just the single bonus.
Okay.
That's so true. I thought you were trying to kill him.
You. So 20?
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
I love talking with you. You have so much to say.
Well, I guess it's time to move on.
Let's do it.
Yeah.
Onward! And upward.
North!
Northbound.
Alright.
Homeward bound.
I wish I was. And see you all begin your trek northward.
Should I insight
check? What is
that
it with these men and not wanting to be where they appear?
I don't really see like why we would have a reason to instantly like Count Christo anyways. Isn't he kind of a douche? He kind of like sounds like...
None of you have
we don't know
been
him.
In...
We haven't really met him, right? But like... We do know that he has been hired for his position, but he is not one of the people. He is clearly someone who represents values that are not apparent, not obvious to us, right?
Well, none of you have been in the country long enough
okay.
to know
yeah.
okay, cool.
whether
yeah,
what you experienced in Kataris was Kataris specific. Or extending to all of Taba.
That's fair.
Okay, cool.
So, as of the moment, you know, all that you know of Count Christo is that he is the ruling regent.
Okay, cool.
Of Kataris.
Of Taba. The entirety of Taba.
Got it.
From Gainsworn.
Okay, cool. So, we don't think, like... Okay, so, like, our characters are probably being like, oh, man... The fat guy is the reason everyone's poor here, but in reality, it's probably a much bigger picture than what we thought it was originally.
Very well, maybe.
Yeah.
We're not entirely sure. Yeah.
Yeah. My hand doesn't do what the guy might be. So I just don't really see why I would even have like a strong opinion on the green guy yet.
Correct.
Probably not.
You would be very unlikely to have much of an opinion.
It was probably
until now
on Little Green.
Yeah, it was probably
a warning. Is this even Little Green?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, who knows?
Just
now we're just
going to
watch every green person.
Count Christo is a...
Who are you? Chris! It's dangerous! It'll give you allergies! Are you green? Are you wearing a green cloak? Sorry.
Well, judgy.
Just asking.
Artemis is, but he's not very little, I don't think.
No.
Timmy's been a tree. What if he was a shrub before?
Well,
I can guarantee
shrubbery.
I've never been a shrubbery.
Oh, right, you're right here, sorry. We are the Knights
of
Sage.
One of my favorite movies.
It's a great musical, too.
We demand.
Yes.
So you all start heading north. Is there anything in particular that anyone's working on during your travel here?
Are we doing like a 80s montage type thing? Is that what's happening?
Certainly can.
Well, if that's happening, I want to start reading the other book, Arcane okay. for Dummies on
oh
this
my God.
Travel.
That's
right.
Use Arcane and use it while walking.
Hold on,
or do I have to sit?
I
didn't
get a fancy
book. To infuse.
You can do it while walking.
Okay.
I want to be bonding with my wolf.
Okay.
And practicing agility.
So I am comparing the description of the mine to what we were looking for, I guess, you know?
Okay.
Yeah, keep an eye out for that stuff.
Does anyone want any fancy infusions on their armor / weapons?
What's an infusion?
I can make things stronger. So, the ones I have a bit available, I can enhance your weapon. It'll only work once, but it'll give you a +1 damage. Or I can do enhance elemental damage, and can deal +1 damage with a selected element once.
My fists are considered weapons.
And I, or I could give you a tattoo.
What's a tattoo do?
It's just fancy.
She thinks
it
about
cool.
it and she's like, oh wait, I'm not supposed to get tattoos. Never mind.
You can't get a tattoo from your deity?
No. Oh. Not yet, at least.
I also have healing infusions if anyone wants to put it on one of their items. Then during battle, you can pull out your own healing rock.
Oh. I mean, if you want to make me a rock, I'll carry it.
Okay.
I will definitely take out a rock.
Can you turn one of my heating stones into a healing stone?
Yes.
I'm going to give you a heating stone.
Okay.
Don't use it.
Okay.
Trying to create an icy hot over here?
Yeah. 100%. I'm sore today. I'm just going to... But also, we're going to the north, so like.
So that's.
Minor heal. I have minor heal on it?
Yep. Okay. So regain 1d4
nope,
+3.
Okay.
And you can use it once.
I dropped my.
But I can always enchant it again later.
On my rock as well?
Yep.
1d4 plus.
3.
3?
Yep. Does anyone else want a rock? I think I have two more.
Oh, you can only have special rocks you can do them on?
No, I can only have a certain amount of infusions going.
Oh, maybe.
Otherwise, you could just have a bag of 1,000 enchanted rocks
yeah.
and
makes sense.
Just
chuck them at people.
Yeah.
Yes. It's just like World of Warcraft instead, just like heal in the back, heal.
1d4
yes.
plus
yes.
3?
Heal.
Yep.
Heal. I played Shaman for a while.
Alright.
Is anybody else on a rock?
I feel like you'll make the right decisions in the moment with them.
Okay.
Yeah.
Then I will just enchant 2 other rocks so I have all of my infusions.
I'm usually too busy holding other things in my hands to.
Yeah, I can't quite be unbalanced if you hadn't noticed.
Yeah.
Things kinda need to be symmetrical for me.
Oh, we've noticed.
I kinda struggle if they're not.
I'm sorry. Because I'm sure my spots bother you.
A little bit.
Yeah, just suck it up.
I know.
Caleigh folds one wing.
Oh, no. Please don't.
She starts laughing and folds out the other one. Ah, just kidding.
You know, it's funny, you said you frequent nightmares. Honestly, I just picture that your nightmares are just like chairs that are slightly creaky or like off balance or something. I'm sure that's just like what qualifies as a nightmare for you.
That's my normal everyday. That's not even my nightmare. That's my waking moments.
I think that I, at some point, will just kind of fall back from everyone else and just kind of be in prayer and talking and, you know. Yeah. Not
okay.
for too extended of a period of time, but like while we're walking.
So you guys are traveling. You're traveling northwards.
Yeah.
And are traveling for a couple of days. This is, you know, it'll take a little while to get to your next main city of...
Did we get any inclination where the mine was?
We got a description, right?
Yeah.
I bolded it in our document online so I could go back whenever. So... Don't know where it is.
Okay.
But we have an image of the entrance.
Okay.
I believe that they said it was north, but that's all about it.
And we are back to full everything?
Yes, yes. You've taken a couple of...
Thank you.
You will get that during a level up as well.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
And then you also have taken a couple of extended rests.
I'm still
it. Okay. So my magic that I used to enchant, I get that back.
Correct.
What was the description of the door, whenever you get a second?
Just a golden glowing door covered in runes.
Every once in a while I'm gonna kind of fly above us, to just see if, like, bird's eye advantage will see, like, a glowing door.
That makes sense.
Okay.
Yeah, can we keep an eye out while we're walking? I assume we're all just constantly keeping an eye out.
Yeah.
How long are we walking?
Couple days.
You've been walking for a couple of days now.
Yeah.
All right. So you all are heading north. And you travel for a couple of days. You haven't come across anything strange. You're just traveling along. You're traveling along the main trade road heading north?
Mm-hmm.
Or are you staying off the road? Are you staying to back roads? What do you... How are you all traveling?
We have any reason to stay off the main road.
Yeah, I feel like we're just, you know, walking along.
Yeah.
We're pretty tough. never mind, leave Olivia.
You do come across a couple of caravans on your way, heading north, heading south, different crossroads, and you pause a little bit with them, and you help replenish some of your stocks, and continue on your way. You guys continue to travel alone, or do you want to group up with one of these caravans that you're coming across?
How big are the caravans?
Well, there's numerous varying sizes that you come across, all the way from 3 wagons. There's one that's 40 wagons. Some of them are a couple of merchant trains. Some of them have some solid guards with them.
Oh. So it's a matter of, like, protection?
And faster travel?
Probably faster.
We travel faster with them, or would they slow us down?
Horse and carriage?
They would be likely to be about the same pace as you, because they have people walking and on carriages. Some of them, you know, the ones that are just the wagons,
you could try and team up with ones that don't have guards and see if they'll pay us a little tiny bit of money to protect them.
Oh. But what if we do end up coming across the gate? The door to the mine.
We just ditch them. We
could do a per day
freelancing way of doing it, right? Like, we'll walk with them. Something happens, they'll pay us. But, you know,
nothing happens.
So you guys are going for one of the smaller caravans heading north.
Yeah.
One without guards.
Yeah.
If they want, a little assistance. Yeah.
Okay.
Need a little muscle.
So you one of them, it's a little 5-wagon caravan. It's 3 farmers and a merchant and another merchant. So 3 farmers and 2 merchants. They are heading north towards Manda, which is in the capital hold, but it is a couple of days south of the capital. I'd say it's about a week ride to Manda. As you guys are, show you guys the map. Manda is your approximate destination of where where it said was a good starting spot.
Okay.
So, and this is on the drive for you guys as well if you want. But you guys
start
the other way.
Upside down. There we go.
Yeah, it's upside down.
So you guys are, we're starting down here by Kataris.
Okay.
And Manda is up here.
Oh, got it.
Yep, way over here.
Okay.
Perfect.
Cool.
So you've been on the road for 2 days now, and this caravan says that, no, they're planning on reaching Manda in about a week. And so you're going to offer your services of protection?
Yep.
Sure, yeah.
Well.
How are you doing so? What are you all doing? You've walked up, you've engaged in a little bit of conversation. It's mealtime, it's lunch, so they're, you know, they're taking a little pause, and you come across their little cooking fire.
Does any have any decent diplomacy?
I do.
Shit.
Let's see, what is
it? It's two elves.
I do, actually.
Goliath and
five.
His family.
Besides athletics and endurance, it's my next five.
A catfolk.
Aww.
And a goblin.
Don't trust the goblin.
Oh,
Now we're gonna be racist towards everyone.
What color is the goblin?
Green.
Ah, fuck.
I told you.
What's your diplomacy?
Two. Four.
Okay, I'll go up.
Yeah, I'm gonna
I'll come with
each of the elves is a farmer. The Goliath and his family are currently farmers whose farm was destroyed and are moving. It's actually burned down by some soldiers, so they are moving on to try to make a new home elsewhere. The catfolk and the goblin are both merchants. The goblin is the only one with a full covered wagon. The rest of them are with an arch cover for anything to sit, and everything else is just.
What's his name?
Oh, yours is higher.
Yeah, because I can add half.
You want all their names?
Well, just the fourth one. My wings are away. Just heads up.
The goblin's name is Kazel.
Okay, I was just curious if it was.
It may be.
Yeah, I guess I'll say, well, if you like, I can talk to them.
Go for it. I'll come with you.
Please do.
Yeah.
Walk up to the group they're sitting right now.
Yeah. Enjoying a light lunch.
Okay. Hello, friends.
Hello. Come join.
What?
Unless you're soldiers, at which point, move along.
Soldiers, we are not.
Says the Goliath.
I assumed that voice.
Hey, I mean, that could have been an elf.
It could have been the goblin. That would have been
also that.
I wish.
The goblin, yeah. Well, where are y'all heading?
Okay, y'all.
We're heading to Manza.
Well, that seems to be the way we are traveling.
I figure most caravans heading this way on this road are probably heading to Manza. At least for their next stop.
Yeah, well,
Manda
the next
and
main
Manda
scene.
Are two different places, right?
Sorry, Manda.
Okay,
Manda.
I was going
to
say.
Manda.
They are. That is correct.
Yes, Manza is the
just a little bit further north, yeah.
Manza is the capital. Manda is not the capital.
Okay, so are they heading to Manza or Manda?
They are heading to Manza.
Okay, thank you.
I'm not sure if you're looking to hire anyone to protect your caravan.
Well, a couple of us can hold our own, if need be.
Why do you travel together as a group, always?
Just for the last few days. Week almost. Time drags on the road.
I know what you
mean. I want to get back to the homestead.
Well, my friends and I would like to propose, maybe. For a small fee, we could keep you safe on your ways there.
Oh.
Traveling in numbers is always a good thing.
And are you part of the, you part of the, Guild of Fighters or the, Guild of Security? What are your... Why do you think you can protect us?
Well, how many people do you see have wolves as their companions? We are very...
Okay,
cunning.
You like animals.
See, yes.
And
we have Pointy Sterling. This wonderful, shiny being.
And he's going to stand up. And how tall are you, Sterling?
I am a modest 8'4".
Cool. So he is a full 10-foot Goliath.
Holy!
Standing head and shoulders, weighs almost 600 pounds, behemoth of a Goliath, and just looks down at you.
Oh, wow.
Am I supposed to be impressed?
Well, am I supposed to be impressed? I mean, because they are, the harder
to, like,
they fall.
The middle of his chest.
So you're telling me, and I point to Chodrak, I'm like, you're telling me that he probably couldn't do any damage? Is what you're thinking.
I'm just holding the wall.
I'm just wondering why we should pay you to protect us when... I'm just asking for qualifications. And you point out your largest member as a qualification. And I am saying, if size were a qualification...
It's very true. You bring up a good point. We got these wolves. Should I tell him?
You got the wolves.
Probably doesn't care.
I see.
I don't want to hurt the wolves' feelings, but we got these two wolves by killing its
alpha.
A
soft one. I see.
Well, how
I don't want
you
to
say...
traumatize it further because it watched in front of... It had to watch us kill its alpha.
So you care about animals?
Yeah.
Good for you.
Well, do you speak for the entire group?
No.
Oh, well then, I walk away. And I go to the farmers. Hello, friends!
Which farmers are you walking to? He's one of the farmers.
Oh, the other ones were the elms or something?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Hello, friends, I say in... Did I take Elvish? Elvin.
Sylvan. Right?
Or Sylvan?
No, there's Elvish.
Oh, is
and
there?
Sylvan. Sylvan is the language of the Feyland.
Ah. Okay.
Evelyn, yes.
Good day. We're in polite company here. We try not to speak in a language that not everyone can understand.
Switch to common. I understand. We're just wondering if you'd like to... If you're looking for some help along the way, north. We're
well,
heading that way.
I think... He was asking you about qualifications. Are any of you part of the Guild of Fighters or Guild of Security or...
We're mixed guild, actually.
Oh, wonderful, wonderful. Are any of you part of the Guild of Fighters or Guild of Security?
No one is?
No.
No.
No, yeah. No adventurers. Your character's Guild of Adventurers.
Guild
don't
of
mind.
Adventurers.
Damn
yeah.
it.
Well, no, we are not, but I guess...
I'm not there.
I mean, if you're going to ask for money to protect us, then, I mean...
We would only ask for money if we encounter something, not to just walk alongside.
Oh, well, that's a different story. I mean, like, if we wanted to hire guards, then we would hire someone from one of the guilds, or at least someone that proved themselves in combat against, you know, things that might have to fight. Otherwise, it's kind of a waste of our money, right? But, I mean, if you want us to pay you if we get attacked and if you succeed in fighting something off, then, well,
That's certainly not opposed.
I feel like that just seems more reasonable for all parties involved.
Sure, sure. Okay, what's your fee for a battle?
I guess, like we're saying...
I'm gonna do
an appraise check and see what would make sense for...
Perfect.
Appraise check?
Yeah, that
beautiful.
Thing.
Beautiful. Beautiful.
Hey, look at that. Practice
skills. I'm not good at that.
I'm actually decent. 12.
Okay.
I didn't roll decent.
So, I mean, you have never hired somebody to help fight a battle for you.
Right.
You know that...
None of us have.
Typically, guilds get contracted to bring people out for an entire caravan ride. And they might get paid, depending on the distance, between a handful of silver to a handful of gold. To be here for the whole time.
Mm-hmm.
Per battle, a couple silver, maybe.
Relay information that I think I know.
Well, what if we did 1 silver per person beat?
Make a diplomacy or persuade.
We're gonna diplomacy the shit out of this, y'all.
Yeah, you go.
I just jinxed myself, damn it. Hey!
Apparently not.
24!
Nice.
Nice.
I think that arrangement could be... I think we could make that happen. 1 silver per being you defeat.
That's fair.
Much more inclusive way of saying it. I reach out my hand.
And we'll reach out and shake it.
I thought you were supposed to be good at this stuff. As we walk away.
I spent 24 years by myself.
Yeah, it's weird that you're good at this stuff.
I speak to the witch. I speak to the wolf.
I speak to the witch!
And then before that, 20 years with the one witch.
It's okay, you did really great.
Did you mean that insight check?
Okay. Insight against my insight? Insight against my what?
This will be against...
I think you were lying, so...
Well, start with this.
Bluff.
Are you lying, or are you...
Yes.
Make a bluff check. Against his insight.
Oh, my bluff is shit.
Their insight.
There, yes.
Is that a 5?
That is 5.
That's 7.
18.
God damn!
So, are you lying?
Kaylee's fingers are, like, crossed behind her back as she's walking away and forgetting that her fingers are crossed behind her back.
Oh, thank you very much. I appreciate that.
You're welcome! And then, like, realizes her hands and goes...
Alright, so you all travel along for another couple of days. On the third day, you roll into a small town, relatively unremarkable, and the caravan is going to remain here for the rest of the day, and they'll leave the next day. It's actually going to grow in size. You guys are adding another 6 wagons.
Whoa.
And the goblin is going to split off and take a... different route towards
intimidated by us.
To Manda.
We were throwing too many weird looks in his direction.
Yeah, we were being real rude.
While the rest of the group continues on towards Manza.
Manda.
Should probably change that name.
Manza.
And you guys want to go towards Manda.
Oh.
But we don't trust the little girl.
Well. Not yet.
How far does the path diverge from one to the other?
Well, from here, I mean, it'll take you another 4 days to reach Manza, and then it'll take at least 2 days to get back to Manda,
Whereas if you were to go to Manda straight from here, it would probably take you 2.5 days.
So he's just taking a separate route because it's shorter.
Yeah, because it's shorter.
Yeah. And Manda is closer. Mm-hmm. So yes.
But we did say we'd protect those people if need be. So now I feel weird going back on that.
Well, he was part of
we just said till we were.
He was a part of those people. And would the new people be willing to pay that price?
I'd imagine we had conversations before they joined the caravan.
Yeah. This is side. This is while they're discussing what's happening with their caravan.
I see what goes on.
As much as we're not supposed to trust Little Green, I would like to go.
Is there any checks or anything we could do to try and figure out if we would have any idea of which direction the...
Oh yeah, like map?
The, mine, or whatever might be?
Well, you could ask around. See if there are any legends or anything, but you were told that Manda would be a good starting spot.
Okay.
And that's where Little Green is going.
Yeah.
Correct.
Are we for certain?
Well, that's where he said he was going.
Yeah.
Should try to talk to
him. Huh.
Yeah, he's kept mostly to himself the last couple days.
Okay.
Does he make an announcement to the group of like, hey, thanks so much, we're gonna split off?
Yeah.
Before he leaves, can I talk to him and say,
well,
where
and,
are you
and
headed?
He's still going to leave tomorrow morning as well.
Oh,
so
cool.
You guys have about 16 hours before anybody is leaving.
He's going to Manda.
Yep.
Yes.
Which is
and everyone else is going to
Manza, the capital.
Manza. Okay.
You got you guys concerned with this little green stuff, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah. I say if we're trying to go to Manda, we go to Manda.
Yeah, yeah. We might as well go with him.
We don't try to,
no need to
go
try
up
to...
and then back down.
Yeah, we just offered that if it was necessary while we were traveling with them. We didn't say we were going to stick with them until they got where they were going.
It's true.
Yeah, so if you'd like to go and turn in a resignation notice to the other group.
Why me?
You got us hired. I will just let, you know, Little Green know we're heading his way. No pressure.
I say if we're going
like
to break off
him
from the group, we don't join him and we just go.
Do we
know
we
don't really
going
have
Manda
to wait
for?
Till the next morning if we
don't
want to.
Well, he's a merchant. Other than that, none of you have talked to him.
Yeah.
None of you know anything about him other than...
I'm going to walk up to him.
I'm going to come with you.
Thank
just
you.
For insight.
Great.
But I'm just gonna
I love it. I walk up to him and I just start a conversation like, you've been awfully quiet this trip.
Oh, yeah. I just typically don't talk to lots of people.
Oh. Well, you said you're going to Manda?
Yeah, I am.
What for?
I'm a merchant. I sell things.
What's your favorite thing that you sell?
Well, I typically sell them because I don't like them. If I like them, I keep them.
Oh, I don't know if you made your own goods.
Oh, no, I'm not a crafter. I'm a merchant.
Right. Right. I should know that. Okay. It's like making mental note of like, wait, difference between merchant and crafter. Okay, cool. Okay. Have you been to Manda before?
Oh, once a year, typically.
What are the people like?
They're loud.
Oh.
I mean, most people are loud to me.
Am I talking too loud?
No, you're being okay right now.
Great.
Your quiet friend is great, though.
I like him a lot. Where are you originally traveling from?
Oh, well, I mean, most recently I was at Kataris.
Oh, so are we.
Oh, good for you. I mean, I travel all around Taba. I can kind of do a loop.
Do you pick up any, like, folklore from the different places you go to?
Well, I mean, sometimes when a bard travels with us, they have a lot more.
What's one that you've heard a lot?
A lot?
Yeah.
There's always the story of when Relesia attacked and Gainsworn came to the rescue.
Do you think Gainsworn really came to the rescue?
Well, I would never say otherwise. It's, you know, it's digging camps. I don't want to be at a digging camp. I'm a merchant.
Right. Do we know about the digging camps?
This is the first you're hearing of the digging camps. This is the first you're hearing of the digging camps.
What?
I was 5 when I left.
How much interaction with people did you have on your travel upwards to Kataris? Did you mostly keep to yourself, or did you...
I probably did not talk to a lot of people because... Okay.
First, you're hearing about the digging camps. Not that you all are here at the moment, but first you're caring about the digging camps.
Okay.
You might have heard mention of it before, but you, meh, okay, they're digging, so what?
Yeah.
Lots of people dig.
Yeah, right.
You are familiar with the digging camps. You've spent enough time amongst people that you at least have heard of fear about the digging camps, and you know that people are regularly selected for it, especially when they live somewhere.
What are the digging camps?
Well, they go out and they go digging for something. None of us know what, but they're out looking and digging for something. They've been doing it for as long as any of us have been alive.
And how do you go to the digging camps? Or why are you scared of going to the digging camps? Is it not like, I'm gonna go decide to do that, or?
Oh, no. Those that, that go, well, I mean, every child at 14 is supposed to go to the digging camps. And, you have to spend 4 years either in the digging camps or the army.
Oh.
And, well, I went to the army. I didn't have to go to the digging camps. Not everybody comes back. And then every year, well, this really only applies to people that like live in the cities. So I haven't had to deal with it yet because I travel. I'm a merchant, you see.
Yeah.
I'm a merchant. I haven't talked this much in a long time, but you seem like there's something good about you.
I'm not from around here, and
something
I just want to learn.
Seems strangely nice. So I just feel like I should talk, so I don't talk much.
Well, I'm all ears. We have 16 hours to burn.
So, every town and city, a group of people is taken to go join the diggers. They don't get to stop being part of the diggers.
That sounds scary.
Yeah. So I keep traveling.
So
I don't,
you don't have to be chosen.
Uh-huh. Because I don't have an address for them to come find me. So I have a wagon.
That's pretty smart.
Because I'm a merchant. I'm a traveling merchant.
Even better.
Can I insight check him even though he seems trustworthy?
Yeah, absolutely.
I will.
To trust the little
I will
man.
Give you guidance. Guide whatever the heck it is. Hold on. Hold on. Yes. I'm going to spend 2 magic. I will give you guidance. Guidance. And you can re-roll the last. You have an advantage.
Nice. 20. Dirty 20.
Okay. So, you haven't found anything. There, you get the feeling there's something he's not saying.
Mm-hmm.
He's not quite saying everything that he could be saying. Whether that's him lying about something or just maybe not saying all of his details, you're not quite sure.
Mm-hmm.
But he hasn't said anything thus far that you immediately believe is a lie.
Just withholding a little bit.
Yeah.
I'm going to keep that to myself for now.
Okay.
Well, I guess you're smart for not having an address.
I try. Yeah. I'm a merchant.
Well, what are you selling?
I sell a lot of things. Are you looking for something in particular?
Nope. I just like things.
Oh. Well, I mean, I have glass. I have jewelry. I have books. I have shovels. I have a couple of
I have
of
a friend
pickaxes.
Who would really like books, and I like cut him off. Maybe when we get to
Manda,
we can look at your books.
Okay, I can bring them out for you. People don't come into the wagon.
I'm gonna give you like a look.
I like uh-huh. Oh no.
I'm gonna have you make
oh,
a
no.
each of you make a
Shit.
Sleight of hand check.
Oh, no.
Or a case could be made for bluff.
No, wait, 10. No, 11.
13.
Natural 20?
Ah, oh, fuck.
No.
Shit.
Yeah. You're not gonna rob me, are you?
Oh, God.
Please,
no.
Please don't. I said you looked nice. Please don't rob me.
I gave him the head nod of... Do you want us to come with you to protect you, since you don't allow people in your wagon?
Seems valuable.
Okay. I'll pay each of you a silver.
That's fine.
To stay with me.
Yeah.
Promise
we won't rob you.
Okay.
We were trying to figure out exactly if we wanted to go to the capital or if we wanted to make a pit stop, and you saying that kind of helped us.
You're welcome.
Yeah, thanks. I should go talk with my other friends and make sure that they're okay.
Okay. I'm leaving in the morning.
Sounds good.
It's gonna be dark.
Yeah, we don't want to travel at night.
I'm staying in the inn.
In Manda?
No, there's a little
oh.
in the town.
Oh.
Small inn. It's a trading post with a handful of houses scattered around it, more than anything else. So there's a small inn. It's a general way over station.
Sounds good. I will let you know before it gets dark if we're gonna join you.
Okay. I'll see you in the morning.
That
I'm leaving
too.
Shortly after dawn, because then it'll be light.
Right. Okay. See you soon.
Okay. Bye.
Bye.
He's gonna hop down from the wagon where he'd just been sitting for the last couple of hours and head on towards the inn.
Walk away. Look at Chodrak.
Is he holding something?
I know I said we wouldn't rob him, but I don't want to rob him, but
someone should go peek.
Yeah, I just want to go peek. Let me rephrase that. I'm very curious what is in this wagon.
We didn't say we wouldn't look, because we wouldn't rob him.
I
love
you, Chodrak. I relay everything to the group.
So what's he do?
He's a merchant.
Wow.
A traveling merchant. He is not a craftsman, so he doesn't make anything. I asked him what his favorite thing to sell was, and he said, and he looked at me crazy, like, well, I wouldn't be selling it if I liked it. And I was like, oh, right.
So what does he sell?
Mirrors and books.
Oh, I know someone who likes books.
That's what I said.
Who doesn't?
And he said that we could look at his books when we get to Manda. Oh, he'll pay us a silver to go with him. Each of us.
Oh.
Cool. But he said that he'll let us look at his books when we get to Manda because no one's allowed in the wagon. It really makes me want to look in the wagon.
I mean, that's fair.
Just saying.
Well, I'm not opposed to it, but maybe when we're on the road and not in a city?
Yeah.
Less people to see.
Sure.
Yeah, we're in a caravan.
I'm not a shady person, I'm saying. I don't do this shit.
Well, but he's not here anymore.
He's been
anymore,
around
right?
A lot of shadows, so.
But I
would
help. Don't believe me, I would help.
But I mean, he's not here now, right? And as we're traveling to Manda, he will be here. And he'll probably stay on his wagon.
Did he leave his wagon to go to the inn?
Yep.
Oh
no.
What if he put protection stuff on his wagon?
You could check.
Yeah. I could probably make an arcana check to see if he has it protected magically.
It's up to you guys.
You
I can't
even
make the
decision. Advantage on arcana checks to detect magic.
Oh my god!
You wrote it down last time!
How do you?
I guess.
Or something like that.
Yeah, I just asked about it at the beginning of this session. Oh, look at that. Detect magic, free ability.
And?
Shit.
Advantage on Arcana to identify runes, texts, and things I see. Runes, texts, and things I see. Oh, I see
you
this card.
You see the wagon!
Are you sure you can see the wagon?
Yeah, I'd like to do an Arcana check.
Or
to see
do you
if
have
it is
hazy vision?
Magically.
Delicious.
Wait.
This is not caviar liftings.
I will first ask the group before I do this. I'm like, is this what we want to do?
I don't know.
We can at least start by checking.
Well, we should tell him we're going to sleep by his wagon to protect it. Or maybe not tell him shit.
I mean, he's inside the inn. He's not even.
Are there any windows?
He didn't even ask anything about his wagon, so.
Yeah.
He just left it.
Yeah.
It's just a plain boxed or covered
with cloth. With an arch cover. The edges are drawn.
Mm-hmm. Well.
So you can't immediately see in, but.
I would like to try.
Okay.
What are you trying?
Arcana check?
Are you using detect magic or are you using an arcana check? Detect magic will let you learn if there is magic there. Arcana check will let you determine more what spell could
be. Well, I guess first I'll do a ritual and spend 10 minutes.
Okay. Sounds good. At the end of that 10 minutes, you determine, in fact.
He might have magic items in there, I don't know.
I don't know.
Could that be the lock? Would be a magic item. Inside.
You take 2 unreducible damage.
Oh!
As you start to bleed out of your nose and your ears.
2.
From the strength of the magical spell that is on that wagon.
Wow.
Mm-hmm.
Run
away!
And it's coming from the actual wagon itself?
It is.
No wonder he
Okay.
Now, you don't know anything about this spell.
Yeah.
It could be a spell to not rust. It could be a flight spell. It'd be a pretty powerful flight spell.
Yeah, I don't even want to...
Well, could maybe be a
spell that allows
for
teleportation there.
I don't know if I want to delve in farther.
Oh, never mind.
I mean, I want an Arcana check now to see.
Go ahead.
How close do I have to be?
Trap.
I mean, just close enough to do this.
Okay. You're 10 feet away right now.
So Arcana, I can add my Charisma.
I'm nowhere near the wagon.
Look back.
I don't know where I am, but I don't want to be near it.
Charisma mod. Plus? Charisma mod plus half?
Yes.
Charisma, okay.
I love it.
Or, sorry, no, yours, it's just Charisma mod, because okay. The half level's already in the Arcana.
Okay.
What's in the box? What's in the
So, plus 9, with advantage.
Wait, but what's in the box? Yeah.
Oh, 24.
Okay.
Meow.
You take another 2 points.
Oh, fuck.
About invisible damage.
Okay. Maybe this away from what do I find out?
And at this point, you've been able to determine that it is not a protection spell.
Oh.
That's do you want to keep going?
Oh, man. Another Arcana check?
Yep.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Oh, my God, man.
Okay. It's not protecting anything, but there's something strong there.
And.
Did you guys get a... Is there something squealing?
The eating stopped, but it was replaced by a squeal.
Oh, no. 8 plus 9, though, is... 17.
Ooh. You take 7 points of damage this time.
I guess I should go over and start healing Absidee.
He has the rock.
You actually cough up some blood this time.
I hear him cough. I turn around. I'm like, Absidee, stop it!
As Absidee looks at you and just has blood coming out, hand is like covered in blood.
This isn't worth it!
And,
You wanted to know.
Don't blame me!
Who did this to me?
I'm not talking to you for the rest of the night.
It is also not a flight spell, and it also doesn't seem to be coming from the outside of the wagon. It seems to be coming from inside the enclosure.
Okay, well, I can tell you now it's not a protection spell. It's something inside is very powerful, so you can take a look. I think it's safe.
As they're covered in blood!
Do you need help?
Oh, it's fine. I'll just take it. I will sleep this evening.
Okay. Will you?
Cough up blood.
Oh,
gosh.
Tastes weird.
Oh, no! Actually, what I'm trying to say is we should probably leave this wagon alone.
Yeah, that's why I'm trying to be nowhere near it.
Give a wound.
And then...
Did the 17 damage get...
Seven.
Oh, 7. I heard 17.
No, and just 7.
Oh, good. Okay.
Otherwise, yes, but...
Yeah, and then I'll do it again.
Okay.
No, you don't.
Nice.
Natural 20.
Okay.
Oh, I forgot about that.
As a kiss.
Putting him in the box.
Oh, yeah. I haven't gotten one yet. I kind of look like a more realistic version of Squirrel.
13.
Well, what is 45 quartered? Or half? Wait, what is... How much you got to take?
In a single one? Quarter.
Quarter.
Hold on.
Quarter, 45.
I can't math.
12.
Oh!
20.
11.25. And I roll a d8.
Thank you. Yes.
One.
Bye. I guess it could be worse, probably.
That's not bad.
One item you are wearing or wielding gains the broken condition.
That's fine.
You thought so hard, it broke one of your stuff.
He was holding something, and he goes, ah!
Yeah.
I don't have much. Let me go to my equipment.
Not working
one of
much
the pages
either.
In the book goes. Can't read part of a paragraph.
Not gonna make that go. I'm gonna use my dagger, but.
If someone can craft and fix
yeah.
it. It
I mean, if you would like it to be my book on Arcana that I've been reading.
Oh,
I probably have that. I probably have that out yeah. in far. So my book on Arcana for Dummies.
It's now ripped in half.
It's ripped in half. All right.
I'll glue it back together for you.
Will you please stop? I don't yell. I whisper.
So, it is definitely coming from the inside. And it is one spell that you can tell. It's only one spell. And it is... it's got a couple of different pieces to it. One piece is a concealment. And another piece... It feels like a teleportation spell, but that's not quite right. You have not encountered exactly this kind of magic before.
Hmm. I actually will stop there. Yeah, I'm done. I relay this information about all of that stuff in there to the group.
Hmm. Okay.
You think he knows what it is? Or do you think he just is selling an item?
What's that?
He probably knows what it is.
Oh, he doesn't let people in the wagon.
Yeah, he knows what it is. If.
Yeah.
But we pretend we don't know.
Well, you need to get cleaned up, and we should all probably go to sleep. Now, my main question is, are we going to take the silver apiece and travel with him and go to Manda, or are we just going to continue on with the large caravan?
Well, we need to be in Manda. I say we travel with him.
Okay. Well, we'll tell the group in the morning.
So, like, one piece of silver per person per day?
No, for the whole journey. We're only... It's 2 days?
Total. Yeah.
Yeah.
2.5. You'll reach there evening of the third day. Afternoon,
yeah.
Evening of the third day.
Cool. I really figured we were just trying to go to Manda. I was trying to find an excuse to tell the other group. And also, I was so curious of why he was so quiet. Why are you so quiet?
Those who know lots speak little.
She turns around and goes... She turns around and goes... Hmm. Okay. And just walks away.
Ouch, that was definitely a... backhanded.
Perfect. Pat Caleigh on the head.
You'd have to jump.
I mean, he would. I don't have to.
Oh, because you're... Yes, okay, great.
Yeah.
I thought you said he would pat me.
Oh, no, I will.
I have no idea.
And there's no...
offensive. I don't have any social skills at all.
I think that makes it even better.
There's no outer wall or anything.
Mm-hmm.
To this.
No.
Okay. Well, I mean, I guess I'll set up my...
A couple of fences at best.
I will set up my tent and just go to bed. I don't want to spend money.
That makes sense to me.
I really wish we had some place to sleep in. That was
well.
Than last
time. You want to know something?
Yes.
I've been keeping a secret myself.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. Boom! Tiny hut. Look at it. It's so pretty.
It looks like a rock.
Yeah, it's a shiny rock.
Hmm.
And then I like touch each one of them on the shoulder and I was like, now step into the rock.
Okay, I'll step into the rock.
I roll up my tent. Back in my bag. Step in.
Ta!
Right. Now that you stepped into the rock, it's, well, it's slightly hazy where the walls were, but that's it. It's
very nice.
Yeah.
So we can watch the stars while we sleep.
What
does
it do?
Hmm?
Will it protect us?
Yeah.
That's right. It's not even hazy. It's just...
Clear.
You... Now... The rock went away.
Oh.
Hmm.
So everyone else can see the rock. No one can see in. We can obviously see out. And nothing can come through it. So step out of it and throw a rock at it.
Okay.
You step out and there's the big rock again. And you throw a rock and it goes...
If she's in it right now, there, you're in it. What if I cast a spell through it?
Nope.
Can she hear? You can hear through it, though? Oh. No spells either?
Can you hear through it on the outside? Oh.
Yeah.
No spells. Impenetrable.
Okay, well, I'll take my 8 hours. I'm going inside.
Okay.
Hop into my...
Is there space for us all to roll out bed rolls in there?
There is.
Oh, it's a burst of three.
Cool.
Get my bed roll out.
It's up to 10 others.
Put my hood over me. Tight.
Sleep like a mummy.
All right.
Yes.
You all head to sleep, and you wake up in the morning. It's an uneventful night. What do you do?
We find... Oh my god, did I even ask his name?
Nope. I have it.
You guys found it out at the beginning.
Okay. It's, it starts with a Z. Ah, Kazel.
We find Kazel.
Yeah, that one.
And we go forward.
Alright. You all, head through the first day with, no abnormalities. And the second day with nothing strange happening. You guys doing anything in particular on these days? Continuing what you guys were doing before?
Still training my wolf to jump over things.
I'm going to practice keeping an eye out on the world around us and just kind of see if I can spot things as we go along.
Okay. I'm still going up and down trying to look for this golden
as
light.
As you all are continuing, it is definitely getting notably colder. There is snow on the ground. And you guys are gaining altitude, too. You are heading into some mountains. Who's got any kind of cold weather gear?
I do.
I'm impervious to cold, right?
On the way, I'm trying to stick my book back together.
Anyone want to help with a craft check?
Yeah, I will help.
What's an explorer's outfit?
Not cold weather gear.
Do we have, like...
I have heat.
Do we need cold weather
craft?
Stuff? As the animatrons? Because we don't need to, like, eat or drink or any of that?
No, you will not freeze.
Okay. 17.
Yeah, you're good.
I fixed a book. Here you go.
Thank you so much.
If it gets too cold, I'll take out I will talk to our friend and ask if we can gather around the wagon closer, and I can light a heat stone in 20 feet around us for 24 hours. We'll be warm. If it gets that cold and we need it.
I feel like we should probably buy some cold weather gear when
100%! Did we think about that? No!
I did, but I didn't think we would need it this soon.
I have some because I was heading north to visit my family anyways. And from the whole 5 years I lived there,
I mean, I have multiple clothes, so I could layer, but...
Yeah, just layer up all the clothes you got from...
All the clothes I have.
...Brick Sarah's mansion.
Yeah, I have.
Walks around like a cupcake.
Fancy clothes. Just have a couple layers on, you know.
It's armor as well.
What? Are you not getting enough love?
Put on...
Oh, you poor beast.
10 pairs of clothing, plus one to AC.
Right.
Minus two to dexterity. And dexterity.
And, third day, the sun rises, you travel along, and, you turn a corner on a mountain, and over there, you see a
little city.
It's maybe a quarter of the size of Kataris, because Kataris was a hold capital, But you see it over there. This one does have a small wall. You can see it's wooden palisade. So a whole bunch of wooden sticks stuck into the ground. But it looks inviting enough.
as you all get closer over the next number of hours, and then lunch comes, and you guys push on through lunch. You guys are close enough, and you want to get to the city. Early afternoon, the sun is starting its downward descent, and you come to what you would say are graves. And but these are, they're open. They're about the size of a grave, but they are open. And as you look in, there is three bodies. There are three bodies in each one. You all want to pause and there is a headstone at each one of these. You want to keep walking?
Open?
They're open.
And there are bodies. Mm-hmm. What? I guess I want to like to check it out, see how far along decomposition is.
I want to read the headstone.
The ones you're at right now are very early in decomposition, so it smells a good bit. It seems like the first ones you came to were freshest, and then they seem to be starting to get older.
Humans or all kinds of sorts?
All kinds. And on the headstone, it says, attempted desertion from digging crew. Ooh. Crime. Or punishment. Death. And then has a date. And each of them is identical in that way.
Mm. That's horrifying.
Wow. Yeah, I keep moving on.
I don't think we want to stop and get sucked into one of these digging crews.
Why would you even say that? we're not from here, though.
I'm not sure it matters.
Look. She just keeps walking. Very confused.
Yeah. Keep on going.
All right. These are every 10 feet. Here's another one. And another one.
Along the main road?
Along the main road.
Ooh. I look That's at our little fine. Green friend and say, is this common at every city?
Oh, no. These are typically only where the larger digging operations happen.
Larger what?
Digging operations. You know, where they're looking for
something.
Yeah, something. None of them remember what. None of us remember what.
Seems dumb.
Timius is gonna incite him.
Yeah. I was kinda hoping.
Me too.
You guys picked up on it.
So 19.
Yeah, go ahead.
I'm going to as well because I realized I have a pretty decent insight.
You're going to call this bullshit again. 21.
21?
Yeah.
15.
Okay. Oh, yeah,
23. So the two of you definitely caught him say they and then correct himself to we. And you get the feeling that they is more accurate than we. That they don't remember what they're looking for. Maybe not including him.
Mm. Oh, man.
So we're the only ones that picked up on that?
Yeah.
Correct.
We're really good with our head nods. I know.
What do you two want to do with this information?
I'm assuming we're all still, like, with him, so...
Yeah, traveling, walking.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Do we ask for clarification who they is? Oh, my God.
I don't have the social skills for that.
Someone want to jump in through the back of the wagon?
What?
No way.
Jump into the back of the wagon?
I'm not stumped.
I mean, I was curious about checking it out. I guess at this point, we'd make a look, and then I'm going to try to sneak into the back and peek.
I'm going to distract him by saying, who's they?
They, bluff check. And
me?
Yes.
I'm actually curious who they is.
Yes.
Oh, okay, fine.
Sleight of hand.
Sleight of hand. Or acrobatics.
Nine.
Oh, shit. Where'd it go? What's that say?
15.
Okay. Am I doing bluff?
Yes.
16. No, 17.
Okay. And what was Chodrak's?
Nine.
And are you doing sleight of hand or acrobatics?
Acrobatics.
Okay.
I was trying to see if I had that one, but...
Oh, I meant to say we don't know what they are digging for. He is immediately defensive, and you can tell this. Even you can tell this.
I'm trying to scramble him back.
you take one solid leap. Do you want to use Step of the Wind to help you here?
Yeah.
Yes.
Take advantage.
With my acrobatics, then?
Yep.
Okay. 19.
Okay. Spend your one magic for that. And so you just leap up and you push off the air and you just shoop right into the back of the wagon.
Sorry, I'm still trying to piece this together, my, like, player. He said that they don't know what they're looking for, and then corrected himself to we.
Mm-hmm.
And now he's defensive that he said they.
Yep.
I don't know what to do with that. Genuinely.
We're all friends here.
As if maybe... What it's getting at is maybe
he's not part of it.
So if they don't know what they're looking for, maybe he knows. We don't know what they're looking for. Says he doesn't know.
Got it. Okay. Sorry. I really was struggling. So was Caleigh. Okay. So he's becoming defensive. She'll take that as a... Oh. Well... What do you think they're looking for?
I don't know.
Are you sure?
Go ahead and make an insight check. But if you roll lower than a 10, use your insight defense.
Insight defense. Okay. That's a nat 20.
Nice. Throw an X in there.
No.
Yes. So I get to add a checky. I haven't done that yet. Sorry.
Yeah.
In the green box.
Okay.
I don't know what they could be digging for. He is 100% lying through his teeth. At this point.
How far are we from the...
Best guess? Hour?
Well, I think that you and I know very well that you at least have some idea what they're digging for. And now, if we are going to be protecting you for the last bit of this journey, you should be very transparent with us. And I try to intimidate him.
All right. Intimidation check.
Why did I say that? Because I wanted to! Okay.
Is everybody else just walking along listening to this?
Yeah.
You are.
Coming along.
You are.
You are. Oh, that's a 9. It's a 12.
I don't think I have anything horribly helpful. Could I use thaumaturgy behind her to, like, make... Her seems scarier.
Take advantage.
Yes.
Nope. Increase the shadows.
Yeah, that's still a 12. We'll go with the 12.
I. Oh, very well. And he reins in his ox.
Oh no.
He what?
He reins in his ox.
He stops the cart.
I may know a little more than I said.
Mm. Yeah, I thought I've...
You just dive into the back. And you closed your eyes as you dove in, not knowing what you were going to expect, what was going to happen. And you stand up and open your eyes. You don't hear anybody. Your eyes are closed for a full 10 seconds. You don't hear anything that they're saying right now. You don't hear them talking. You did hear them talking a moment ago. And when you passed in, you don't hear them talking anymore. And then you open your eyes. And that's where we'll end for tonight.
Hey everyone, thanks for watching our newest library of Taba video. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and feel free to check out our other campaign going on right now, the Pillars of Sypetia. They're a pretty wacky group over there, and we have some real interesting shenanigans. Tune in next week, and we'll see you then. Thanks!